होप यू कैन लिसन माई वॉइस. इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डन अबाउट वी हैव सीन अबाउट MBO, दैट इज मैनेजमेंट बाई ऑब्जेक्टिव. आई होप वी हैव गॉट दैट थिंग MBO. नाउ टूडे वी विल स्टार्ट आफ्टर दैट. टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट about the decision making approach, decision making, how we can take various decisions, what are the different theories behind these decision making approaches. We will go through that. But before that, I want to add one thing. I have given you one MCQ assignment. It's because many of you have requested me to give some example of some MCQs. As we are listening, we are getting that the exam will be online, so it is expected that it will be MCQs. But the thing is, regarding that, I want to tell you one thing. That is, though it will be MCQ, the thing is that you have to study all the notes very carefully, because when it is MCQ exam, that means question can come from any part of your syllabus. Okay, so you have to go through your syllabus very minutely. Each and every line you have to study. So I've given you one example in that 20 MCQ questions. I will provide you more later on. But before that, we have to complete our syllabus. Exam is not very far away. It's very near, actually. So we have to complete our syllabus as far as possible. And meanwhile, I will provide you more MCQs. I have provided one example. 20 question MCQ are there. Go through it. Submit it in the Google class within the stipulated date. The date is mentioned. The submission date is mentioned over there. So that is the thing. Now let's start our today's topic. Now today's topic is, as I told you, decision making process. Now, for a manager, decision making is very important thing. For any manager, actually, decision making is very important thing. In any organization, decision making capability, the people who have decision making capability will get some added advantage. That's because in crucial time, quick decision taking ability is very important. So, if we see the definition of it, the very bookish definition is that a decision is the conclusion of a process by which one chooses between two or more available alternative courses of action for the purpose of attaining a goal. The meaning of this is that whenever you have to take decision, in most of the cases, we have to take decision as because we have several options in front of us. So among all these options, we have to choose one option. So that is the scenario. And we are doing that for some purpose, obviously. We are taking decision to solve some problem. So obviously, we have some purpose. So that is written over here. Now, this process is called decision making. And managerial decision making is synonymous with the whole process of management. That means management, we know that there are several processes of management. Decision making is applicable to each and every stage of management processes. At any level, a manager can have to take a decision. So that is the thing. Managerial decision making, that's why it is written, managerial decision making is synonymous with the whole process of management. So that is basically the thing. Now, to illustrate this idea, we can say that planning involves a series of decisions, such as the what should be done, when it should be done, how it should be accomplished, where it will be performed, and by whom it will be performed. So these are the questions. These are the questions which is related to planning process. So the questions I'm repeating again. Planning involves various series of decisions such as what should be done, ki amake korte hobe, kokhon korte hobe, kibhabe amra korbo, kibhabe amra implementation ta korbo, kothay korbo ebong kara korbe, kara oi process tate kara involve hobe. So that is basically, that implies basically decision making process. As I told you, if you have any doubt, you can raise your hand at any point of time and you can discuss if you have any doubt about anything what I'm saying. Okay. People are joining. One minute, I'm taking your attendance. So, according to R.C. Davies, he has told that management is decision-making process. According to R.C. Davies, it is management. He has told that management is a decision-making process. Okay, it is followed by the second function of management called planning, right? So we know that in management there are few functions. Among them, if you remember, planning is the second function. Now decision making is related with planning. So if we see the different steps of decision making process, then we can found that at first we have to define and analyze the problem. What is the actual problem? We have to define that, we have to analyze that. So that is defining and analyzing the problem. Next, we have to develop the alternative solutions for it. That means whatever the problems we are facing, we have to develop different alternative solutions for that problem or against that problem, whatever you say. Next, we have to evaluate the various alternatives, that which alternative is better for us. So we have to evaluate the alternative solution. What is the most suitable solution? What will be the most suitable solution? We have to evaluate all the available solutions and find out what is the most suitable solution. Then among them, obviously, selecting the best solution, and finally we have to implement that decision. And after implementing that decision, we have to follow up that how the things are going on, whether we are able to reaching towards our solution or we are going far away from the solution. So that follow up is very necessary. So that is basically the decision making process. That is, at first, we have to define and analyze the problem. What is the actual problem? We have to define and we have to analyze, we have to understand that thing. Then we have to find out, we have to develop different alternative solutions for that. Then we have to evaluate all the solutions. Finally, we have to select the best outcome, best solution among the alternatives. Then we have to implement our decision and we have to follow up so that we can check that whether we are going, whether we are able to meet the solution or we are going far away. So that is basically decision making process is, we say. Okay. Now, if we come to the various decision making approaches. Now, approaches to decision making, there are various approaches. Like one approach is known as rational approach. One approach will be known as behavioral approach. Another approach will be known as practical approach. another will be known as personal approach. There are various other approaches as well, but these are some prominent approaches. Rational approach. Rational, the term rational means we should not be biased. The approach should be rational. It should be unbiased. Rational approach, then behavioral approach, then practical approach and personal approach. So these are some approaches to decision making. What is rational decision making process? You can see from the picture. In the rational decision making process, at first you have to identify the problem. Then you have to establish the decision criteria. That means on the basis of which factors we will going to take the decision. Suppose my factors are to increase the productivity, to decrease the labor cost, to improvisation of the manufacturing process, and all that. Suppose these are some criteria. So based on that criteria, you have to establish those criteria at first, that on which criteria you will going to take the decision. Prachi, tell me. Yes, Prachi, you can unmute yourself. Prachi, do you want to tell me anything? Prachi Thakur, you have raised your hand. Do you want to say anything?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Angry Bird.
Okay. So, the thing is, what I was saying, that we have to establish various criteria, and then we have to take the decision. So based on some established criteria, we have to take the decision. Okay. Next, after the establishing the criteria, decision criteria, we have to put weight on various decision criteria. That what criteria is most important for us, what criteria is next to it, what criteria is after that. Like increasing the productivity, that criteria is, suppose that criteria is most weightage criteria. That is the most important criteria. So establishing the, increasing the productivity, we will put more stress on it. After that, the second stage may be improvisation of the production procedure. So that may be the second important criteria. So in that way, you have to put weight on your criteria. That means you have to prioritize on your criteria. Your criteria will be prioritized by you. So there is weight decision make criteria. Next is generate alternatives. That means after that, when you have several alternatives, or you when you have got all your criteria actually, and then you will try to generate the several alternatives. So several alternatives will be generated by you, several solutions will be found out. Then you have to evaluate the alternatives as previous, and finally you have to select the best alternative out of them. So that is basically the rational decision making process. So at first identify the problem, you have to identify the problem, then you have to establish the decision criteria, then you have to put weightage on every decision criteria, what you have found out, and then you have to generate alternatives and then evaluate alternatives and like that. Then finally select the best alternative. Okay. So that is the rational decision making process. Chayan. Chayan, tell me.
Hello, sir. Ekta student dhukte pachhe na.
কিছু করার নেই, এত দেরি করে ঢুকলে কি করে হবে, বারবার বল তাড়াতাড়ি।
না না, ওই মেসেজ করলো যে স্যারকে ঢুকতে দিতে।
আচ্ছা তাড়াতাড়ি এ করতে বল। কি নাম? নাম কি চয়ন?
হ্যাঁ স্যার, কিংশুক নাম, কিংশুক।
এখনো তো তাকে দেখছি না, যাই হোক ঠিক আছে, আমি ওকে। হ্যাঁ কিংশুক, ওকে। সো দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাবাউট রেশনাল ডিসিশন মেকিং প্রসেস। সো দ্যাট ইজ রিটেন ওভার হিয়ার। স্টেপ ওয়ান ইজ আইডেন্টিফাই দ্য প্রবলেম, স্টেপ টু ইজ এস্টাবলিশিং দ্য ডিসিশন ক্রাইটেরিয়া, স্টেপ থ্রি ইজ ওয়ে ডিসিশন ক্রাইটেরিয়া, স্টেপ ফোর ইজ জেনারেট অল্টারনেটিভস, and step 5 is evaluate alternatives, and step 6 finally selecting the best alternative out of it. Okay. Now here is a question for you. You see the question, you can see the Gilberts have a large family with 12 children. They need to pick a new car that will serve everyone, including four teenagers who are driving age or approaching it, jara very recently hoyto license pabe. Their criteria include safety, gas mileage or mileage, whatever you say, mileage, reliability, and sitting for 14 person. So they are following the rational decision making process so that they can have a family discussion without heated words. That means jate tader moddhe kono jhogra jati na hoye jay ei niye je keu bolche ami eta better, keu bolche oita better. এইভাবে যেন না হয় সেই জন্য তারা একটা রেশনাল ডিসিশন মেকিং প্রসেস এর থ্রু দিয়ে যেতে চায়। এন্ড হোয়াট ইজ দ্য নেক্সট স্টেপ, দ্যাট মিনস চুজ অ্যামং অল্টারনেটিভস। তো আই মিন দ্যাট উইল বি দ্য অ্যান্সার, অ্যাকচুয়ালি এটা বোধহয় দেওয়াই আছে। যাই হোক, দ্য থিং ইজ দ্যাট আইডেন্টিফাই দ্য প্রবলেম, জেনারেট অল্টারনেটিভস, ওয়ে ডিসিশন ক্রাইটেরিয়া, নান অফ দিস। মানে এই স্টেজে কোনটা নেক্সট স্টেপ ওদের হওয়ার কথা, এই এই জায়গায় ওরা দাঁড়িয়ে আছে যে গিলবার্টস হ্যাভ এ লার্জ ফ্যামিলি উইথ 12 চিলড্রেন, দে নিড টু পিক আ নিউ কার দ্যাট উইল সার্ভ এভরি ওয়ান, ইনক্লুডিং ফোর টিনেজার্স অফ দ্য ফ্যামিলি হু আর ইন দ্য ড্রাইভিং এজ অর অ্যাপ্রোচিং টু ড্রাইভিং এজ। দেয়ার ক্রাইটেরিয়া ইনক্লুড সেফটি, গাড়ির সেফটি তারা ক্রাইটেরিয়া, গাড়ির মাইলেজ তাদের ক্রাইটেরিয়া, রিলায়েবিলিটি তাদের ক্রাইটেরিয়া, দ্যাট মিনস হাউ গুড দ্য কার ইজ, অ্যান্ড সিটিং ফর ফোর পার্সন। সো দে আর ফলোয়িং দি রেশনাল ডিসিশন মেকিং প্রসেস so that they can have a family discussion without the heated words. What is the next step? Basically, next step ta ki hote pare. So, ekhane jodi amra dekhi, they have identified their problem because they know what they want. So, they have identified their problem. So, that is not the next step. Generate alternatives is another option. Weigh the decision criteria, another option, or none of these. Which option is most suitable? So, basically, ekhane, রিলায়াবিলিটি এবং 14% যাতে ওই গাড়িতে যেতে পারে, অ্যাকোমোডেট হতে পারে। সো দ্যাট ইজ দেয়ার ক্রাইটেরিয়া। সো নাও হোয়াট উইল বি দ্য নেক্সট স্টেপ, দ্য নেক্সট স্টেপ উইল বি, আমরা যদি এখান থেকে দেখি এই চারটে অপশন থেকে, তাহলে নেক্সট স্টেপ উইল বি দি জেনারেট অল্টারনেটিভস। তাদের নেক্সট স্টেপ হবে জেনারেট অল্টারনেটিভ, যে কোন কোন গাড়ি মার্কেটে আছে যারা তাদের এই ক্রাইটেরিয়াগুলো স্যাটিসফাই করতে পারে। সো দ্যাট উইল বি দেয়ার নেক্সট স্টেপ, জেনারেট অল্টারনেটিভস। এবং ফাইনালি তারপরে যে স্টেপটা আসবে সেটা হচ্ছে চুজ অ্যামং অল্টারনেটিভস। সো তাদের নেক্সট স্টেপ যদি হয় এই চারটে অপশনের মধ্যে থেকে, তাহলে যেটা জেনারেট অল্টারনেটিভস। ওকে, সো ইন দ্যাট ওয়ে উই মে হ্যাভ সাম প্রবলেম, দেন ইফ ইউ ফলো রেশনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ, then we have to find out the criteria, that which criteria we should keep in our mind when we are generating alternatives. So these are the criteria: safety, mileage, reliability, and 14% accommodation. So based on that, if these criteria are identified, then our next step will be obviously to generate the alternatives, and then finally we have to select the best alternatives among them. So that is the thing, that is the thing. In that way, we try to solve the problems. So basically, there is an example of it. Now, after rational approach, behavioral approach. Now, what is behavioral approach? In the behavioral approach, we assume decision makers operate with some bounded rationality rather than with perfect rationality. Now, that is our difference. In the behavioral approach, we assume that our decision makers, jara amader decision ta niche, jara amader jonno decision ta niche, tader je decision making approach ta, she decision making approach ta, tara jokhon ei through diye jacche, they are operating under some bounded rationality rather than perfect rationality. Now, what is the meaning of bounded rationality here? That means decision making based upon a magnificent, meaningful subset of relevant information. That means we know that, suppose we know when we are selecting a car, suppose our criterias are, our perfect rationality will be this criteria. That is what I have told you. That is safety, mileage, reliability, and sitting for 14%. But when you are going to implement it practically, if you are finding that all these criteria are not present in any of the options, so that becomes bounded criteria. That becomes bounded scenario. Here, suppose we are getting that, okay, bounded rationality. That means, suppose, okay, safety is there. We are getting safety. We are getting suppose mileage and all that. But we are not getting the option where there could be a accommodation of 14 people. So we are getting, suppose at max, we are getting the accommodation of 10% is possible. So that is basically bounded rationality. So here we have to take decision based on that. So we have to sacrifice one point from there. We have to sacrifice one point from our criteria. So that is the decision making based upon a meaningful subset of a relevant information. That is basically behavioral approach. When you are actually going to implement practically, you are getting that, okay, it is not possible. Galaxy 17 raised hand. I don't know. Put your name over there. Galaxy J7, somebody. So I cannot allow you. So the thing is, characteristics. What is characteristics of this behavioral approach? Procedures and rules of thumb reduce uncertainty. Sub-optimizing, that means accepting less than the best outcome. As I told you, that our best outcome jodi hoto, jodi tokhoni hoto, jodi oi je kota option amra chaichilam prottekta criteria jodi satisfy korto. But the thing is that we have to accept less than that thing, because we don't have any option. Jekhane oi charter moddhe oi jemon oi mileage amra pacchi, amra safety pacchi, but amra 14 accommodation pacchi na, we are getting 10 accommodation at max. So that's why there is sub-optimizing. Then satisficing, that means choosing first encountered alternative that solves the problem. That means here in the behavioral approach, we are choosing the first alternative that solves the problem. The alternative ta first amra pachi jena amader problem ta ke solve korche, we are taking that as our solution. So that is basically behavioral approach. So mudda kotha hocche, in behavioral approach we have to accept the situation which is less relevant, which is less satisfying than the perfect one. It is not perfect. Our this solution, we are finding out the criteria which is not perfect, which is maybe lesser than the perfect somewhat. That is basically a behavioral approach. This is practical approach. This is very much practical approach. Next is practical approach. There is another solution which is known as practical approach actually. Now in the practical approach, what we do, we combines the steps of the rational approach as well as combines the steps of the behavioral approach. Okay, so that means practical approach that gives you the practical solution. Tumi jodi dhore boshe thako je okay ami charte criteria jodi satisfy na kore ami gari kinboi, suppose like that. But that is not possible, because in the market there is no such solution. So you have to accept something which is not actually perfectly meeting your criteria. So what you are doing here, you are applying a realistic approach. So that becomes practical approach. Practically jeta sambhab amra shetatei jacchi. That is basically practical approaches. Next is hybrid approaches. You know from the name, hybrid approach, that means we are combining various approaches that becomes hybrid. So here managers use a combination of rational, behavioral, and practical approaches to make decision. That is, that becomes hybrid approach. Now, research has shown that speed in decision making is not indicative of the consideration of fewer alternatives by managers. This is the thing. Research আমাদের এটা দেখিয়েছে যে এটা এরকম নয় যে suppose managers are not considering every alternative solution মানে তার সেই দিয়ে মানে এরকম ভাবে কিন্তু আমরা আমাদের decision making process এ speed up করতে পারি না. We cannot speed up our decision making process by considering less alternative approaches. That is not the case. Okay, so research has shown that. So whether a manager is considering all the available solutions or whether the manager is considering the some lesser alternative solutions, whatever they are in front of him or her, that will not going to affect the speed of the decision making. Okay, so that is basically hybrid approaches. So in case of hybrid approach, what we are doing, we are combining all these rational, behavioral, and practical approach. Now here you can say that sir, behavioral approach and practical approach is somewhat similar. It is somewhat similar because in behavioral approach also we are ready to sacrifice some of our criteria which is not possible to achieve, possible to get. So yes, but practical approach is more practical than behavioral. In behavioral approach, still we will try to find out as max as possible to satisfy our all criteria. But in practical approach, it will be there in our mind that okay, I will not get all the criteria. So whatever solutions will be there in the market, I have to accept from there. So that is basically practical approaches. Now another approach is the personal approach. Now personal approach is something which is making your decision making process individualization. I mean individually. You are taking some decision. So individual decision making can be viewed as a process of conflict resolution. Conflict resolution means some confliction is happening. Suppose like here it is said the Janice Mann conflict model characteristics. He has said that deals only with important life decisions. That means you have to concentrate on the very important decisions. Now, procrastination and rationalization are human mechanisms for avoiding decision making. Then the fear of making an unsound decision can be a deterrent to making any decision. It provides for self-reactions and decision makers can be ambivalent about alternatives. The meaning of these things is that when you are going for personal approach, that means here you are not being rationalized. You are not rational. You are taking it personal. That means personal means you are taking it from your own thinking. Whatever you think that this will be best, whatever you think that this will be better. So you are going for that. So that is basically the personal approach is. So there are different approaches, as I told you, starting from a rational approach to personal approach. Next, decision-making styles. I'm coming to decision-making styles. But before that, if you have any questions from whatever we see, whatever we have discussed, you can ask question. You can raise your hand. If you have any question to ask from the whatever we have জিজ্ঞাসা করতে পারো ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ এনি কোশ্চেন যেগুলো আমরা করে এলাম এতক্ষণ যেগুলো করলাম এর মধ্যে থেকে যদি কারোর কোনো কোশ্চেন থাকে প্লিজ আস্ক মি বিকজ ডিসিশন মেকিং প্রসেস ইজ ভেরি ভাইটাল ফর এনি ম্যানেজার এভরি ম্যানেজার শুড হ্যাভ গুড ডিসিশন মেকিং অ্যাপ্রোচেস এভরি ম্যানেজার শুড হ্যাভ গুড ডিসিশন মেকিং ক্যাপাবিলিটি নাও দ্যাট ম্যানেজার ক্যান follow rational decision making process, that manager can follow behavioral approach, manager can follow the practical approach, as well as manager can follow the personal approach depending on the situation. So that's why in personal approach, we have said that deals only important life decisions. That is, that means the decisions which are most important, the decisions which are most important, we should concentrate on that thing. So that is basically personal approaches. Okay. So do you have any question on that? Please ask me. My one question, yeah. Well.
Rational approach or personal approach?
Rational approach or personal approach? তো কথাটা কেটে যাচ্ছে আমি যেটুকু পেলাম সেটা হচ্ছে রেশনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ আর পার্সোনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ একটু অসুবিধা হচ্ছে তো রেশনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ হচ্ছে সেই অ্যাপ্রোচ হোয়ার উই আর ফাইন্ডিং আউট দি ক্রাইটেরিয়া আইডিয়াল ক্রাইটেরিয়াস আইডিয়াল ক্রাইটেরিয়াস হোয়াট উই শুড হ্যাভ অ্যান্ড উই আর ট্রাইং টু অ্যাচিভ অল দিস ক্রাইটেরিয়াস দ্যাট ইজ বেসিক্যালি রেশনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ রেশনাল কথাটার মানে হচ্ছে আনবায়াসড ইট ইজ নট বায়াসড টু এনিথিং সো যেটা আমাদের অ্যাকচুয়াল ক্রাইটেরিয়া হওয়া উচিত আমরা সেই আইডিয়াল ক্রাইটেরিয়া ধরে উই আর ট্রাইং টু ফাইন্ড আউট দি সলিউশন দ্যাট ইজ রেশনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ পার্সোনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ ইজ সামথিং ডিফারেন্ট পার্সোনাল অ্যাপ্রোচ যেটা বলছে সেটা হলো এই যে সাপোজ আমরা এখানে যেটা বলেছি যে প্রোক্রাস্টিনেশন অ্যান্ড রেশনালাইজেশন আর হিউম্যান মেকানিজমস ফর অ্যাভয়েডিং ডিসিশন মেকিং এই যে কথাটা এর মানে হচ্ছে এই যে প্রোক্রাস্টিনেশন কথাটার মানে হচ্ছে যে আমরা কোনো একটা পার্টিকুলার প্রসেসকে কোনো একটা পার্টিকুলার টাস্ককে উই আর পোস্টপোনিং ইট আমরা অ্যাভয়েড করতে চাই অনেক সময় হয়তো যে আমরা অ্যাভয়েড করতে চাই আমরা অনেক প্রবলেম তাকে অ্যাভয়েড করতে চাই সো প্রোক্রাস্টিনেশন কথাটার মানে হচ্ছে তাই এখানে আমরা আমাদের যে প্রবলেমটা বা যে সলিউশন মেকানিজমটা এর ক্ষেত্রে আমরা সেটাকে অ্যাভয়েড করছি যে আমরা ওই প্রবলেমটার দিকে যাব না এবং এটা হচ্ছে আমাদের হিউম্যান বিং আমাদের যে হিউম্যান মেকানিজম তার একটা জেনারেল ক্রাইটেরিয়া তো এখানে আমরা যেটা করছি সেটা হচ্ছে আমরা শুধুমাত্র সেই ক্রাইটেরিয়া গুলোর দিকেই তাকাচ্ছি যেগুলো সব থেকে ইম্পর্টেন্ট যেগুলো না হলে আমাদের জিনিসটা আটকে যাবে এবং যেটা সব থেকে আমরা যেটাকে সলিউশন করতে পারবো ব্যাপারটা এইখানে সো দ্যাট ইজ ওয়াই ইট ইজ পার্সোনাল এবার কেন পার্সোনাল বিকজ তোর কাছে মনে হবে সলিউশন প্রবলেম এক্সট্রা সলভেবল আমার কাছে মনে হতে পারে প্রবলেম ওয়াইটা সলভেবল তোর কাছে মনে হতে পারে প্রবলেম এক্সট্রাই ইম্পর্টেন্ট আমার কাছে মনে হতে পারে প্রবলেম ওয়াইটা ইম্পর্টেন্ট সো দ্যাট ইজ বেসিক্যালি ইট ইজ ডিপেন্ড অন দি ম্যানেজার ইট উইল ভ্যারি ফ্রম ম্যানেজার টু ম্যানেজার যে কোন ম্যানেজার কোনটাকে বেশি ইম্পর্টেন্ট মনে করছে সো দ্যাট ইজ দি অ্যাপ্রোচ ডিলস অনলি উইথ ইম্পর্টেন্ট লাইফ ডিসিশনস আই এম কামিং ইন দ্য নেক্সট সেশন দিস সেশন ইজ টাইম নেই নেক্সট সেশনে জয়েন কর আমরা আবার তারপর থেকে করছি হ্যাঁ জয়েন আসছি নেক্সট সেশনে আয়